Your B2B sales cycle is long, you have large and complex deals, and are facing multiple decision makers, ABM might be a good strategy for you. Welcome to HubSpot Tips and Tricks. I'm Jasna from Actuado, and in this video, I'll explain how to set up ABM, account-based marketing, in HubSpot. ABM, account-based marketing. HubSpot's definition is that it is a focused growth strategy in which marketing and sales collaborate to create personalized buying experiences for a mutually identified set of high-value accounts. Usually with ABM, we get a smaller number of leads, but more qualified. We personalize the messages for a small market or a company. The tactics that we use are, for example, high-value offerings, such as valuable small-scale events or gifting. We create custom sales enablement content, like personalized videos or demos or custom pricing documentation. And we create custom web content, like landing pages or microsites or chat flows. We also use personalized ad journeys for an account or individual stakeholders. Of course, for these tactics to work, we need to have all these data points for a company that fits our ICP, Ideal Customer Profile. And we need a lot of content that resonates because, as mentioned, the sales cycles are long. HubSpot includes ABM in their Sales and Marketing Pro and Enterprise plans. Don't be confused by the labeling, as it doesn't say ABM, it says Target Accounts. So you go to Contacts and then choose Target Accounts. I already mentioned that the deals are complex and require multiple decision makers. And here you can see what the roles are. Blocker, budget holder, champion, decision maker, end user, executive sponsor, influencer, legal and compliance, or other. Of course, don't necessarily have all these roles for a certain company. You need different information as they have different pain points. You probably wouldn't address legal and compliance and the champion if you had them on a call with the same information. So you want to craft the messages for each of those roles, especially regarding the objections they might have. HubSpot Target Accounts help you deliver those messages to the right place in these roles at the right time. If you have a list of contacts in legal and compliance, you can drag them to a page with additional smart content added, and that content addresses the pain point of a typical persona in legal and compliance. But a prerequisite is, of course, that you have them in the CRM. You may have just one role in the CRM, and you can add other roles in the CRM based on the information you get from LinkedIn. To get them in HubSpot, you could start a conversation on LinkedIn or perhaps as a follow-up email or in-person association event, and then try to lure them to your website where they could be able to sign up for a relevant ebook, a webinar, a report, a checklist, or something else that they would find relevant. And since they are your target account, these assets might be created just for this company or a particular industry you're targeting. Let's take a look what we can see. On the top, you can filter by the owners, the team you created in HubSpot, and your ICP. You have three tiers, so we can segment them further. You can also choose the industry and the lifecycle stage, and I can't stress enough that without data in the CRM, you can't have segmentation. We are on a demo account, so some of the data is missing, but we can see if we take a look at Coca-Cola that there are five contacts. Four of them have a buyer role and one doesn't. We can change that if we have the information quite easily. You can also see that I'm an internal stakeholder, the only one at this account. So you know if there are several people in your company working on the same account, you would see them here. You also know what their activities were, so it's really transparent. If this was a real account, we'd also see their engagement. So when these contacts were last on the website, replying to our email, or booked a meeting. Adding a target account is easy. You can go to the page, click on this orange button, and choose the company. For those of you familiar with HubSpot properties, you can also change the target account property on a particular company to true. Finally, you can also create a workflow based on the criteria that changes this property to true once the criteria are met. Here's an example how it would look in real life on an active HubSpot account. You can see the new contacts, one-on-one emails sent, locked, calls, and meetings. You also have all the roles on the dashboard, and you can see both the last touch and the last engagement, so their engagement with you. For two contacts, you don't have the role or any information on the last touch or engagement, as you probably don't have them yet in the CRM. What you could do is add the role based on the job title that you can find on LinkedIn, but there are also some platforms that integrate with HubSpot and would fill that out for you. Another bonus for the target accounts are also the target account reports you can find in the report library in HubSpot. Currently, there are 26. And an additional tip, even if you don't execute ABM yet, you can set it up in HubSpot for more important accounts or companies you want to sell to. This will enable you to track them and their contacts in different roles on one dashboard in a more efficient way. Do you have any questions? Let me know in the comments or send an email to hubspot@actuada.com. Like, subscribe, and share our videos.